Hello friends, welcome to my channel tutelf.com. The topic that we are going to discuss today is velocity time graph. We have already done distance time graph and graph. For that you can check my other videos. Continuing with velocity time graph, I'll have my time on the x-axis because it is an independent variable. It is an independent variable, and velocity would be on the y-axis because it is a dependent variable. If you want to know about this dependent and independent and how to plot a line graph and how to find the slope, please check out my video on graphs. So now let's see how I'll make this. So I'll have my x-axis and the y-axis. I'll make the original point. I'll put x-axis on my time on the x-axis with the units as seconds. I'll put velocity on the y-axis with the unit as meter per second. Now I have the time varying as 0, 5, 10, 15, 20. So the gap is of 5, which is uniform. So 0, 5, 10, 15, 20. Ensure that you use a scale while making the difference. Now I'll write the scaling. For x-axis, I have 1 unit for the 5 seconds that is there. And for y-axis, I'll just first initially put on the scaling. Just hold on for a second. So since it says 30 for each, I can have a 10 division. So for 10, 20, 40, I have nothing. So what I'll do is, since the difference is of 10, so one unit represents 10 and the unit would be meter per second, since velocity is in meter per second. Now I'll plot the graph. So for 0, I have 30. For 5, I have 30. For 10, I have 30. For 15, again, I have 30. And for 20 as well, I have 30. So it is a straight line. I'll just join it, which is parallel to the y-axis. Now I'll draw a perpendicular from both the side, and I'll name as ABCD, and I'll be finding area under this line for ABCD. Let's have a look at this graph in a more visual form. So that is how my graph looks, and I've written the x-axis, y-axis, and everything. So as you can see, that this area below, it's a rectangle. So for a rectangle, the area is given by AB times CD. Now what I'll do is I'll just write AB times CD. So my value of AB is 15 minus 10. So this will give me 5 seconds. I'll just write 5 here, 5 seconds. And CD will give me, so it's AB times BCM. So sorry, I've written CD. So it's AB times BC because it's the product of length into length times breadth. So BC here is 0 to 30, that is 30. So I will have the answer as 150. Now let's check out the unit. So for AB, the units is second, and for BC, the units is meter per second. So the final units would be meter. Now we all know that since, you know, velocity is given, so what I have received here is, this is the unit of distance or displacement. So since velocity is given, so I got the answer as displacement. So we can say that the distance time, for the velocity time graph, the area under the graph gives us the displacement. Continuing with this, let's check out another graph. So I have time, I have velocity, I'll make the x-axis, y-axis, I'll put in the zero initials. Now I have time on the x-axis with seconds, and on y-axis I have the velocity, I'll put as velocity meter per second, since that's a unit. Then I have my velocity with the gap of 9 and the time with the gap of 5. So I'll have interval of 5 seconds for the x-axis and interval of 9 meter per second for the y-axis. Scaling would be 1 unit for x-axis equals 5 seconds and 9 meter per second on y-axis equals another unit. So the graph on the right is a little cut. I'll show it to you again. Now for time, I'll be making the graph 0, 9, 18, 27, 36. I have it. Now I'll be plotting 0 for 0. So the point would be on 0 and 0. Then 5 for on x and 9 on y, 10 on x and 18 on y, 15 on x and 27 on y, 20 on x and 36 on y. And then I'll be joining it with a straight line, and I'll try to find the slope this time. So for this area, I'll be finding the slope with you. and the area. So area under the curve, let's have it for A, B, C, D, and E. We'll be finding the area as well as the slope. Let's have a look. So here I can say that this is my graph that you have seen earlier. Now, area under the graph would be the sum of this triangle ABE plus the sum of plus the area of this rectangle EBCD. So area of the triangle is half times base times altitude. So it would be half times. Now base is BE, which is 5, because 20 minus 15 would give me 5, times height, that is AB. Now this is 36 and this is 27, so AB is 9, so that would be 9, and I will be adding this with the area of the rectangle. So area of rectangle, let me just see, it would be EB times BC, because it is length times breadth. So EB is 5 and BC is 27, so it would be 27 times 5. Now I can just calculate this. I'll have it all calculated and I'll write the answer. So since the area under the velocity time graph, it gives me the displacement. So the unit would be meter. I'll just do a quick calculation of this. Just hold on for a second, please. So it's 9 times 5 is 45 divided by 2, it's 22.5 plus 27 times 5. You can easily do the calculation. I can even find the slope. Now slope would be AE, that would be AB, which is 9 divided by BE, which is 5. So it would be 9 divided by 5, which would be 1.8, and the units here would be meter per second square. Now meter per second square is for acceleration. So the slope of a velocity time graph gives me the acceleration, and the area under the graph of a velocity time graph gives me the distance. Displacement. I hope this part is clear to you. Now, if I had a graph like these two, so we can see that there are different values, like the value is not fixed and it's random. So this is the non-uniform velocity graph, and this one as well, because the velocity is not increasing in equal intervals or it is not fixed. So we'll just summarize what we have learned right now. So if I have a straight line which is parallel to x-axis, then it's a constant velocity time graph. That means that the car is moving at a constant speed. Now, if I have a straight line, which is an oblique straight line, then in that case, I have a velocity time graph of a uniform acceleration. For non-uniform acceleration, the graph could be a curved line which is rising up, or a curved line which is falling down, or a random zigzag graph. So it could be any. The slope of a velocity time graph, it gives me acceleration, and the area under the graph of a velocity time graph will give me the displacement. I hope this is clear to you. Let's just do a quick summarization. So speed time graph has, for a constant speed, I have a straight line which is parallel to x-axis. For non-uniform acceleration, I'll have a curved line or a zigzag graph or any kind of random graph. For uniform acceleration, I'll have a straight line. Now, this straight line could be moving up or it could be moving down. This case, this was not a straight line because the points were not at an equal interval. As you would see, whenever you see a graph, you'll get an idea whether the graph has a uniform acceleration or a non-uniform acceleration or a constant speed. For uniform and non-uniform acceleration, you can check out my video to know more about it in detail. Thank you so much. Have a great day. Please do subscribe and like the video. Do leave your comments in the comment section so that I can answer you. Or if you have any suggestion, those would be most welcome. Thank you so much. Have a great day.